What's going on, everybody? Welcome to G Myers World. And what we're going to be talking about right now is the one cut in Madden 19 Ultimate Team, okay? Now, it's obviously available throughout all the modes in Madden, but we're going to be talking about it specifically with Madden Ultimate Team because it's very, very serious to, you know, like depending on how you pick your team and how you put it together, it's a very, very serious decision. Let me tell you what I mean by serious, right? I got three bum running backs on my squad right now, okay? This guy right here, CJ Anderson, he's garbage, but you'll be able to see based on the way he moves. You see like how he just cut in through that? That is determined based specifically on the attributes that he has. And I've been getting a lot of questions about, you know, does it really matter? I chose the rookie premier, Saquon Barkley, because remember, guys, I suggested Saquon Barkley as the number one choice. If you guys remember that, go back to my video. I told you. I said, listen, based on the information that I've been getting from EA Sports and their blogs, they are going to make the one cut more realistic. It's going to be about locomotion and true player movement. And I'm letting you understand right now that that's exactly what it is. So let's take a look at this right here, okay? Now, this is campaign solos. I'm almost done with the campaign solos. I only have one more left. This is actually the playoffs of the campaign solos. So the final 82 or 83 of them, okay? So I'm going to show you right now what happens. Okay, now when you're doing the one cut, right, I want you to understand something. For all of you guys that like to keep your hand on the right, your finger, that's a better pronunciation of what I'm trying to actually explain. Your finger, not your hand, your finger on the R2 trigger, right? You have to be able to let off. Do you see that step? In Madden 18, they weren't able to do that step and just cut right in, okay? This is very critical because changing direction in Madden 19 is going to take your game to another level. And I can promise you this right now. If you focus on one cut early on in EA Access, whenever you get access to play the game, if you focus on one cut starting now, you are going to be a problem when the game is regularly released. Okay? So I want you guys to understand something. This guy, I forgot what Anderson he is. I think he's like CJ Anderson. This dude sucks, bro. You know what I'm saying? But he has certain attributes that's going to help him to get that activated. Now, I had silver cards. He's actually an elite. All right? So I'm going to pause the game right now, and I'm going to show it to you exactly what I'm talking about as far as his attributes go and what you're looking for. Okay? When we go to halfback, you look at CJ Anderson, right? Don't worry about all the strength and all that stuff. You can look at his acceleration, 84. What's his speed? 83. He's pretty slow. All right? His elusiveness is a 70. Okay, that's to show you exactly how important that one trade is right there. Because remember, we're not doing anything else. We're not spin moving. We're not juking. This is straight elusiveness. He's at a 70, okay, activating the one cut. Okay, we're not using spin moves. We're not using stiff arms. We're not using anything like that. No juke, no nothing. Okay, it's strictly at this point about elusiveness. So if a 70 is doing this, can you imagine what a 75 will do? A 80, a 85? Now, keep in mind, EA is definitely going to have to patch the game because there's certain things that are going on and it's already been tweeted about and stuff like that. So certain things are going to happen. But I do believe that the game is going to maintain, you know, the way it is right now. It's going to stay intact the way it is right now as far as the overall gameplay. So what I'm explaining to you right now is the benefits of the one cut and understanding it. Okay, so how do you one cut? Pretty much what you do is you're going to have to let go of the speed burst button, which is the R2 trigger, Xbox One and PS4, I believe it's the same thing. Just the right trigger, the big trigger at the top of the remote, right? As you start to run, okay, you can be holding the trigger there as I'm going to get the edge off of the stretch play. You can be holding it then, okay? Once you see the opening of where you want to take it, okay? Once you see that, you see like how I see the defender, right? I notice where he is. I see that I want to go left now, all right? Now, with the real player motion, you can see that you see how the defender is moving and it's not like fake, like he's not doing Madden 18 stuff like, you know, like the rabbit legs, and it's like it's not doubling. It's individual steps. That's locomotion, right? Now, when I go to make my cut, this is also very, very realistic. He's going for the tackle, right? So, depending on how you have your carrier setting set, like right now I'm on balanced. So, it's not always necessarily true that he's going to break this tackle, but because he's not on conservative, it's more likely than not that he will break that tackle off while he's initiating one cut. So what do I do with one cut? As I'm holding R2 right here, I let go of it right when I'm getting ready to turn. You see when my shoulders get square? You see like right here? I let go of the button. And yes, it's that critical, okay? Let go of the speed button and turn the left analog stick to the direction that you want to do your actual one cut to. In this case, I want to go to the left. So I let go of right trigger and I hold the left stick to the left, okay? As I hold it to the left, he's already putting his foot in the ground. Let's back up right here so you could actually see it. Look, you see that foot right there? He's putting the foot in the ground off of me letting go of R2 and then pressing to the left, okay? So he's already initiating the move. After he initiates that move, you go ahead and you press the R2 button again. That's what initiates me being allowed to break that tackle, okay? So keep in mind, like I said before, my ball carrier settings are set to balance. If you use conservative, they will not be able to break tackles as often as they used to, you know, in Madden 18 or whatever. It's not like that. You can't be on conservative. You got to be careful with what you do. Okay, so look, as I do the cut, all the way up until here, I'm holding the speed trigger. Okay, let go. My shoulders get square. So you see my shoulders right here? Right before I get right there. Hold on. Right about there. Okay, R2, I'm no longer holding the speed burst. Left analog stick, hard to the side that you want to cut. If I was going to the right, I'll be cutting it hard to the right. In this case, I'm cutting it hard to the left. And as soon as I get the animation with the foot in the ground, you see the grass come up off the turf? Okay, bam, R2 again. Because now I'm ready to take it whichever way. Now, if he wasn't there to tackle me, it would have been a much more seamless one cut. Okay, but because he was there to try to tackle me, it created that animation where he'll break the tackle. Okay, that's going to happen defensively, unless you guys start going ahead with your training points and adding secure tackler to some of your player upgrades, you're going to have that issue. And in most cases, you're still going to be able to break it if you execute the one cut correctly. Okay, so it's very, very critical. This whole time, right here, it's what, bro, we're holding the R2. It's all about the speed right here at this situation, okay? So until we get to this point right here where we're going to square our shoulders, push it hard to the left, bam, you can see the foot right there. It's right there. It's in the dirt. It's in the dirt, bruh. One cut. Turf comes up. We're Audi 5000. Audi 5000, bruh. Okay, right back on the R2 because we've already initiated the change of direction. That's all that the one cut is. But it's not the one cut alone that makes it so good. That's not what it's about. That's not what makes this feature so exciting. It's the locomotion and the real player motion. That's what makes it so good because you never lose the fluidity. You never lose it. The fluidity in which he moves never changes. Okay, so he's always ready to make that play. So as he sees him, you have to know at this point, you're letting go of the R2 button. Hard left, R2. As soon as you make the hard left, you're not holding R2. Once you initiate the one step and you see him put his foot in the ground, okay, once the foot's in the ground, R2. More likely than not, you're going to always break a tackle and you're going to always be able to continue to maneuver, okay? Understand what I'm saying to you. Be very, very careful with coaching adjustments. Stay off conservative. Balance seems to be safe right now. I don't know where it's going to be headed going forward, okay? But you're going to want to make sure that you don't keep yourself on conservative right now, because I haven't really seen a lot of fumbles. Obviously, if you get caught up and a dude, you know, he lays you out, like he lines you up and you just stand there and get hit stick, you're gonna fumble the ball. But I will tell you this, it's very, very difficult to be able to line up a hit stick as it stands right now. I don't know what's gonna happen after the next patch. I don't know. Okay, so if you're asking me that, I don't know. But as it stands right now, when you line it up, like right there, you see like how I missed that? Once you line it up and the player, the offensive player sees that the hit stick is coming and they move and alter themselves in any different way, you're going to be screwed over. You're not going to be able to get the hit stick off and it's going to be a wrap. And that's pretty much going to be it. Okay, so this is live in-game. Okay, live in-game footage showing you guys exactly what's going to be needed for one cut. Okay, now as far as the other animations that they do, you're going to trigger a lot of different animations in the game. You'll be able to go under players. You'll be able to push the pile. It's a lot of different things you're going to be able to do, but it all starts with the one cut. You have to master the one cut. Once you're able to logically be able to stop on the dime, you're going to be a nightmare for every one of your opponents. Okay, so what you're going to want to do, if you don't want to practice it in-game, if you're not comfortable right now doing that, all right, that's a hot one, but that's the GOAT Tom Brady, though. That's the GOAT Tom Brady, though, just putting it on me real quick and trying to embarrass me during my tutorial. But that's neither here nor there. That's not what this is about. This is not about me getting doubted by Tom Brady. This is about one cup. So don't even try to play me and let me know that the GOAT doubted me. I'm well aware of that, okay? The dude's the best quarterback to ever live. All right, but listen, let's get back to what we were talking about. When you're on defense, right, the best thing to understand is the alternate, like how to counter it, right? How do you counter the one cut? Okay, this is very, very interesting, and I got to make sure you guys understand that. The left trigger, L2, is the way that you wait, okay? Now, I've already done a couple player friend stuff like that. When you hold the left, look, when you're holding down the left trigger, right, your player stands there. If you move slightly to the left or the right, he slides uncontrollably. But it's not sliding in a bad way like it was in the past. It's real player motion. Like the guy, he completely reacts to it. You see, like how I wasn't able to do that in 18. You see, like how I was able to change direction? That's all locomotion. That's all player movement. That's all real time movement, bro. You guys are going to be in for a treat. Now, again, this is all pre-patch before the first patch, okay? There is no patch as of yet. I'm letting you guys know that EA has already announced that there will be a patch, obviously, because, as I said before, there's going to be certain things that are going to have to be tweaked. I don't think at this time right now that the gameplay is part of that. Hold that block, bro. What are you doing? Yo, Neil, you're a legend. Okay, Neil, you're going to be on the auction house. Bro, don't worry about it. You'll be on the auction house as soon as possible, because I wanted to hit you guys with another one cut to let you guys see what's going on, because I've been actually practicing it a lot, and it's very, very useful. Like I said, let go of that trigger before you make the cut. That's the key, all right? So we're watching our block. Watching our block. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah, bro. All right, yeah. We just got the business. We got the business right there. I ain't going to set trip. Dudes was there. But like I said, Anderson is trash. And we're working at it with a 70 overall elusiveness, okay? So the more elusive, if you get like a Shady McCoy, he's going to obviously be able to get off those blocks a lot differently than other players. Because it's more get. Oh, he just moved him right out of the way too. Oh no, I didn't want to do that, bro. What if you see, like I'm trying to explain to you guys, as soon as you make a movement, you can't stop that movement because it's real player motion. So if you choose to like go in and you really wanted to go in then out, you have to already be ready to change the direction of your player manually. Like the computer doesn't help you with it once you're doing it. You see what I'm saying? So as I go here, I see that, I watch the block, I'm out. Okay. Bro, he just fell on the ground. I couldn't even... he just fell on the ground. You know what, bro? This dude CJ Anderson kind of trash. Get out my game, bro. Get out my game. James White, you garbage too. Let's put in Mixon. Let's see what Mixon got to do. Because he has a little bit decent elusiveness as well. All right? And you can also see that they're stacked to that side. So we could probably flip the play here and see how they line up. Okay, that's how they're lining up over there. Let's try it this way and see how it works out. All right, we're going to go ahead. Hit the hole. Okay. And like I said, remember this, though. Okay? All the while you're trying to do the one cut, you're going to see it's much harder to do the lower the elusiveness. Like right here, Tyreek Hill is a little bit more elusive, right? So you see that? Look. You see how he can just cut and he'll just go to the direction? Right? Oh, we out. You see that speed burst? That's me changing direction instantly. Now, he has a better one cut because he's a better overall player. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at what he's dealing with so we can understand more in depth what the one cut is all about. Okay, we're going to go to wide receiver, okay, and we're going to go to Tyreek Hill, and we're going to go over to elusiveness, and we're going to see he's an 82. And you can see that because of the immediate speed burst he gets. So just like I said, can you imagine what's going to be happening when you get a dude like a Barry Sanders with those legend cards? What's going to be happening with that speed burst? It's going to be outrageous. Like, bro, you're going to have to be strafed up and be backing up and wait for it, you know, just see what happens. Because even with secure tackler, you can't do anything. You're not going to be able to do what you want to do. So we're going to try mixing right here. We're going to try some one-cut action. All right, hold the block. Right, okay. We got to we got to run the block. Now, listen, you see what happened right there? Keep in mind, right, the blocking is a lot better than Madden 18. So your guy is going to actually engage the defender. It's just going to take a little bit of time depending on how far away the defender is. We're going to go ahead and flip the play to the left here, okay? And then we're going to see what Mixon can do going this way. All right, watch. Oh, cut inside. We out. You see that? You see that? That's an in and out. That's in and out play right there. That's what I mean by real player motion. You don't have to initiate one cut. You can just pull off the turbo. And you can see the difference between Madden 18 and Madden 19 right there. Okay? So the biggest thing that I want you to take away from this tutorial is understanding. Let go of the right trigger. Look at how, you see how I see it? He's right there. He's engaged. And he's going to get off of it as he pushes him off. But I see him. And then what do I see with ball carrier vision? I see the other guy right away. So what do? I immediately turn. Okay? And you see the motion? It never stops. It's all fluid. It's locomotion. So you go, and then I'm cutting right in there. So he can't make that tackle. And I got news for you. If that's you as a user, and you're not strafed, you're probably going to give up six. Okay? It's that easy to give up six. Okay? So make sure you understand that. The strafing is key. As I cut in, I let go. That's another one cut. He puts his foot in the ground. Right there. All right? Now I see him. Again, let go. Speed burst. And that, my friends, is the one cut in depth, showing you exactly how you're going to make your opponents are going to be throwing their consoles and their computers out of the window once you master the one cut. I'm going to see you guys and girls next time. One love.